Most people use Procreate masks without really knowing what's happening, or they avoid them completely. But once you understand alpha log, clipping mask, and layer mask the right way, your whole workflow gets faster, cleaner, and way more professional. Get ready to learn all the tricks and stick around until the end, because I will show you a layer mask method that can save your line work, something most tutorials never mention. Let's start with drawing a face. I go to my color panel and pick my color and quickly draw my lines. Then drag and drop my color in. I want to move it, so I hit the transform tool, the little arrow at the top. Then I go to layer panels and create a new layer on top by hitting the plus icon. And I pick a new color. Now I'm gonna draw the hair quickly. I hold my pencil at the end of every stroke to create smoother lines. And when I have a close shape, I drag and drop my color in. Alright, let's talk about alpha log. Honestly, the quickest and simplest of all three. Best for a small layer setup. To check how many layers you can have on your setup, go to Actions and Canvas Information at the bottom. And here you will see your layers number that you can have. On really big high resolution canvases, Procreate actually limits how many layers you can have. That can make working with lots of separate layers tricky. This is exactly why alpha log is perfect. It lets you add color, texture, or shading directly on the layer you already have, without needing extra layers. Alright, let's see alpha log in action. Here is my base layer, just a simple silhouette of a woman. To turn on alpha log, open the layers panel, tap the layer and hit alpha log. Or the quicker way, at pro tip, two fingers swipe right on the layer. You will see that little checkerboard texture appear. That's how you know it's active. Now watch this. If I grab a brush like this one and a new color, then start painting. I want to draw a little flower garden inside his hair, and you can draw along with me if you want, or you can skip ahead if you are just here for the trick. You see, with alpha log on, even though I draw crossing the edges, nothing goes out of the edges. So I can draw very quickly. No cleanup, no erasing the edges, nothing spilling outside. This is amazing for quick recolors or adding creative textures. Or some colorful shading like this. But here is the catch, and this is important. Alpha log is not non-destructive. You are painting directly on the artwork. If you want the original back, you have to undo. And if you undo too far, well, everything might gone as well. So alpha log is perfect when you are working with a small number of layers. Because everything you draw stays on the same layer, just need to make fast, confident changes inside a shape without going over the borders. Alpha log keeps everything inside the shape you already painted. So once it's turned on, you can paint, shade, or add patterns, but nothing escapes the borders. Procreate literally blocks the empty space for you. But if you want flexibility later, or you don't want to damage your base layer, that's where the next tool becomes way more powerful. Clipping masks. This one is a step up from alpha log and honestly one of the most powerful tools in Procreate. And you're gonna use it a lot. Sometimes you want to add shadows, highlights, textures, or color details without touching your original layer. Clipping mask let you do exactly that. Let's see it in action. Add a new layer on top of your base layer, tap it, and choose clipping mask. You will see a little arrow pointing down. That means it's clipped. Now anything you paint stays perfectly inside the underlying layer. Let's try drawing on your clipping mask layer. It still works like alpha log, nothing crossing the borders, but it's on a separate layer. It's totally non-destructive. This means you can experiment freely, tweak later, or even erase without ever damaging your base layer. So your base layer is right under your clipping mask layer. If you turn off your base layer, the clipping mask disappears too, because it has nothing to clip to. But if you turn off the clipping mask layer, your base layer is still there, perfectly untouched. That's the beauty of it. Clipping masks are completely non-destructive. And the best part, you can stack multiple clipping masks on top of a single base layer. For example, I'm creating a new layer here. I haven't activated the clipping mask yet. Sometimes I will draw everything first, like a pattern or texture, then turn it into a clipping mask. Let's say I want to draw a bird. I'm not even sure where I want to replace it yet, but that doesn't matter. I will just sketch it out. Now I go to my layers panel, then tap the layer and hit clipping mask. See how all these layers stack on top of each other and connect back to the base layer. Now I can move the bird around freely and find the perfect spot. I love how flexible that is. You are never locked in. Let me show you another important thing. I'm drawing some leaves here, and watch what happens if I drop color into the shape. It fills the entire hair. To fix that, I need to make sure the shape is fully closed, even at the corners. Once the outline is closed, the color stays exactly where it should. No problem. You can also add as many shapes as you want. The downside of clipping mask is that if you are not careful, you can end up with a lot of layers, especially on bigger projects. But here's how I handle it. When I'm done with a clipping mask and I don't need to tweak it anymore, I just merge the layers by pinching them together. Now I got one clean layer instead of five. You can even merge it down into your base layer if you are completely sure. Okay, let's bring them back. With clipping masks, the order of your layers really matters. Let's say I create a new layer on top of face layer and draw another flower. If I turn on clipping mask, it gets clipped to the face layer, not the hair, because it's sitting above the face layer. If I drag this layer out of the face layer stack, it disappears, because there is nothing for it to clip to. Now, if I move this clipped layer on top of the layer stack that belongs to the hair, it gets clipped to the hair instead. So basically, you can move layers around however you want, but remember, a clipping mask always clips to the layer directly beneath it, not to another clipping mask. So if I want to add more patterns to my clip layers, I either turn off the clipping mask on that layer temporarily or use another masking technique. Okay, back to keeping your layers organized. Merging your layers is one option when you are confident with your drawing and you are dealing with limited layer capacity. But if you don't have a layer limit and you just want a cleaner layer panel, you can simply group everything instead. Just swipe right on your clipping mask layers and the base layer, then tap group. Now you can open and close that group whenever you want. Everything stays tidy, easy to find, and your workflow stays smooth. Just one important thing, make sure your base layer stays inside the group. If you drag it out, the clipping mask will deactivate, and you will have to bring it back to the group and activate the clipping mask again. Clipping masks are cleaner, safer, and way more flexible than painting directly on your base layer. And now let's talk about the star of the mask tools, layer masks. And this is where things get really flexible. Most people just erase parts of a layer when they want to hide something. And as you can see here, while I'm erasing this section, it disappears instantly. But here's the problem. Once it's erased, it's gone for good unless you undo. And the farther you get in your drawing, the harder that becomes. Layer masks give you a better way. Instead of deleting, you hide parts of your layer. And the best part, you can always bring them back. Think of it as a reversible eraser. You can experiment, refine, or tweak without ever damaging your original artwork. This is how it works. Go to your layers panel, tap the layer you want, for example this one, and select mask. Procreate attaches a second invisible layer, that's your mask. You can think of it like an eraser layer. Instead of erasing, you paint on the mask to control what's visible. I will show you how. Important to know before I show you how it works, masks are all grayscale. If you select the mask and open the color panel, you will see the color wheel only shows black, white, and shades of gray. These are the only colors you need because they control visibility. For example, if I move over to pink on the color wheel, it still shows up as gray here at the top. Alright, I'll show you how it works. Let's choose black. You need to paint black to hide parts of your artwork. It looks like erasing, right? But the cool thing is, the original layer isn't touched at all. If I turn off the layer mask, my drawing is still here, completely untouched. To bring it back, hit your color palette, and this time choose white. When you start painting with white, it reveals everything. So black hides and white reveals. Or you can just turn the mask off and the base layer is untouched. Instant fix, nothing is ever deleted. If you choose gray, it gives you soft partial transparency, perfect for gentle fades or subtle shading. The lighter the gray, the lighter the transparency. So basically, if you want to hide a section, paint it black. Want to reveal it again? Paint it white. And if you want a soft fade or partial transparency, paint with gray. Layer mask gives you a total creative control. You can hide or reveal areas, create fades, add shadows or refine details, all without permanently altering your artwork. This makes them perfect for experimentation, adding layers of shading, and keeping your workflow clean. The real power comes from combining all these masks together without ruining your base layer. Let's try it out together. I start by creating a layer mask for my character's face. This allows me hide shapes of that base. It's like creating a cutout from your base layer without damaging it. I draw another flower, just being experimental with the creating a garden in this girl's silhouette. See, even though I deleted this flower shape from the face, my face layer isn't damaged. Let's try adding a clipping mask. Tapping plus icon to create a new layer on top, adding some pink shades around the flower, and then tap on your new layer and then clipping mask. It kinda adds a cool effect around the flower. Because the clipping mask only affects the pixel of the base layer, and the layer mask controls visibility, and you can tweak both independently. If you want to hide more of the base, adjust the layer mask. If you want to change shading or color, adjust the clipping mask. If you are limited on layers, go tap on it and add alpha lock to add more extra color details, highlights, or textures. There are some common mistakes that you need to watch out. First, painting on the wrong layer. Always check if you're on the mask or the layer before drawing. Second, clipping mask order. The clip layer must be directly above the base layer, otherwise it won't work. If you don't check, you can paint on clipping mask layer for a completely different part, like here. And that's all for drawing with masks. Even things get messy, it's all safely inside your layer mask or clipping masks, so you can close them and return to your clean base layer in seconds. Pretty cool. At last, I want to show you a portrait that most tutorials don't cover. You know the struggle. Sometimes you save your artwork with a white background, delete the artwork, and later you realize you need the line work. Nightmare, right? Layer masks come to the rescue. You can actually separate your line work from a white background using layer masks. Here is how it works. Go to your layers panel, select your layer, then copy its contents. Or try shortcut. Use three fingers and swipe down on the canvas, then choose copy all from the menu that pops up. Then go to your layers panel, create a new empty layer with the plus sign, then drag and drop black to fill it all black. This will become your clean line work layer. Then tap the black layer and select add layer mask. Make sure the mask itself is selected. Then paste your copied artwork into the mask. Use three fingers and swipe down on the canvas, then choose paste. At first it might look messy, don't worry. Tap the mask and select invert. Suddenly your line work pops out cleanly on the black layer. Pinch the mask and the black layer together to permanently apply it. And just like that, you got a clean, isolated line work layer with no white background. That's a deep dive into mask in Procreate, alpha lock, clipping mask, and layer masks. If this helped you, hit like and subscribe for more Procreate tips. Drop a comment telling me which mask you use most or share your own tricks. And if you want more in-depth drawing classes, check out my Skillshare classes. First month is free with the link below. Thanks for watching.